A few days ago, I attended a small business expo in Los Angeles and enjoyed watching people enthusiastically work at networking. It always sounds like fun until you actually have to do it, doesn't it? But remember that building your network of prospects is one of the most important things you can do to build your business. Hi, I'm Nelson Davis. With some degree of trepidation, we've all been to events that were billed as networking gatherings. Most of us are shy people at some level, and walking into a room full of strangers is probably on that list of things we don't want to do, right behind having a root canal. But there are always opportunities at those gatherings, and we need to learn how to maximize them. Simply collecting and passing out business cards doesn't quite cut it. The key steps are preparation and taking effective action. First, do your research on who's going to be there and set yourself some targets regarding the people you want to meet. If there are workshops, choose those that will help build your knowledge base. Also, you should have your brief elevator pitch tuned up and ready to deliver many times. Naturally, you have a pocket full of your business cards. At the expo that I just mentioned, I'd taken a different brief bag and was truly embarrassed to find that it held only a few cards. The approach I've learned to use is to engage other people to talk about their business first. Just about everyone likes to talk about what they do. If you ask good questions and listen carefully, they'll tell you about the problems that they're having, and that may spell opportunity for you. Maybe their insurance agent is a pain, or their computer network has let them down too many times. All business owners are looking for help in one or more areas, and if you can offer help, that is the opening that you're looking for. Don't make a sales pitch right away, though. Set your mind on doing some useful follow-up. For instance, rather than sending them an email, my favorite form of immediate follow-up is to send a handwritten note on small cardstock stationery that I've had printed just for that purpose. Sometimes I simply send thank you notes. Most of us get too many emails, you see, every day, and a common edit system is to simply hit the delete button. That's not what you need. I've found that even the CEOs of Fortune 500 companies pay attention to personal handwritten notes. Before sending that note, do some research on the person that you want to have in your network of prospects. Ask for a very short meeting to explore how you may help with that problem that they mentioned at the networking event. Remember, you should be offering something before you get to asking for something. A moment ago, I mentioned that most of us are basically shy people, which I believe is true. My favorite shy story involves Johnny Carson, the legendary host of The Tonight Show for many decades. Back in the early 80s, I worked for the NBC TV network, and I was assigned to work on The Tonight Show. I was pretty nervous heading to my very first Get Acquainted meeting with Mr. Carson, who I'd been watching on TV since I was a teenager. Within the first 5 minutes, we had admitted to each other that we were both shy people, and we had a big laugh about it. But we had both learned to get beyond the shyness to succeed in business. Successfully building your network of prospects, friends, and clients gets translated into that income and growth that you dream of. Your business will never be any better than the relationships that you build. That is the true purpose of networking and learning to do it well. There are two books that I recommend. They are Dig Your Well Before You're Thirsty by Harvey McKay, who's in the envelope business, and Never Eat Alone by Keith Ferrazzi. I found them so helpful that they became favorite gifts for me to pass along to interns in my business. So here are some of the key ideas for great networking. Be prepared to put on your nice clothes, your best smile, and get out of the office to meet other people on a regular basis. The people who can buy your services or products are probably not in your office. Engage with the people you meet by showing genuine interest in them and what they do. Follow up in writing by showing that you've learned something about them and their business. Offer to help with your knowledge and experience. If they're going to do business with you, they have to get to know and trust you. Tomorrow night, for example, I'm planning to attend a retirement gathering with two gentlemen from two very large and well-known companies that were clients of mine. They worked with my company for more than a decade each. Those relationships began after we first met at networking events. Now, of course, at the awards gathering, I'm going to be working that room to develop new relationships as well as nourishing the existing ones. Emphasize the work in networking and you will grow your business. I'm Nelson Davis, and I want to help you thrive and prosper in this entrepreneurial world.